Hello?
Sorry, I think that might have been a bit too loud. Really sorry for that. But we are ready to continue again. For some reason the OBS stopped recognizing the mic. Wow, how long have we had those ships? My wife always tells me she's pregnant, but that can't be right, can it? I'm actually going to try to doubt. I'm actually going to doubt whether or not this is actually my son, because or my child, because if it's a boy, I'm really hoping that. But I can, if it's a boy, that I can illegitimize it, because I do actually want my current heir, who is a female, who is also the Duchess of Saxony, to inherit. He's craven, but that seems fine. I'll hire someone to find out. Yeah, I think the siege is fine. We're also going to try to get that, and try to get her more positive traits and such. Try to groom her as my heir and all that, which is also my current objective. Pfft, whatever. Oh no, someone is trying to fabricate a claim in my empire, a count or something. Oh no. Oh, some actual troops. I must know. I will confront her directly. I can never be entirely sure. Someone used a favor against me in order to do that. Now, in order to get on the council, that's mostly fine, but. Do we have anything? I'm wounded. Let's try dark healing. Satan may take and Satan may give. Hello, and yeah. If you're still there, it would be helpful if you could comment on whether the mic is working. Oh great, we're no longer wounded. The jealous wife of my lover Andre has denounced us both adulterers publicly. Good evening, Sir Brot. And a good evening to you too. We're just doing a little bit of Crusader Kings playing. I'll pay 200 to keep the trade route running. And we've been doing this playthrough, if you're unaware, we've been doing this playthrough for about a total of 250 in-game years. Well, maybe it isn't evening where you are. Well, it is. It actually is evening where I am. Oh yeah, sorry, they think they can take us. Let's just reinforcement. Hey, the French actually might do some good for once. Let's see, are they coming in the right direction? They are, and I think that's gonna pretty much cinch this battle in our favor. We've built some property over here. Let's make some Huskarl training grounds. Was Kunigard just... Oh yeah, Kunigard was just... Yeah, we're going to try to gather 650 for the really, really nice Huskarl training ground there, the capital. Right. Okay, Sunni Revolt, where? Where is the Sunni Revolt coming from anyway? Is it... yeah, it's coming from our actual Sunni territory. That actually makes sense. Go ahead and quash that for me, England. We're gonna need more commanders while we're at it. You seem fine. My boyfriend can be a pretty good commander. We'll put him there. And put some decent commanders on, and yeah, it's only 1/6,000 stack. It's gonna take us a few weeks. The morale's gonna be fine at that point. I don't think we need to pay a lot of attention to that. Yeah, this is pretty much a crushing victory victory for us. We deal around 6,000 casualties and take only about 4. Let's assault that. Let's march over there and get that one over with. Castletown Boyska. Might as well build a castle. Actually, no, I'm gonna just save the money up to make sure that we're getting a Huskull training ground here. That seems like more fun. But yeah, I'm feeling a bit sick right now, so this episode is probably gonna be a bit shorter than usual. This is probably only gonna be like, I don't know, an hour and a half maybe. Like, I can kind of feel that my thinking cap really isn't on. Not that I'm usually that smart to begin with. We're just gonna assault that. Peasants in Oxford. Oh, that's awkward, because then we're probably gonna need to use the Scottish troops? It looks like England can fend for himself on that one. We'll let him handle it. And if it starts to spur a problem, we'll just have to, I don't know, send some to someone. Like, we might even send the French ones after this one's disbanded and such. I accept. Okay, now we've actually taken a few... Yeah, I've managed to fix the mic problem. All it was is that OBS, for some reason, didn't recognize it. I just had to restart the program, that's about it. Oh, we also have... one dangerous increased power faction, and all it is the King of England and the King of Hungary. That's not something that's great. And I would really wish if he had someone to marry off my half-sister to. Okay, I'll do that. That marriage will do just fine. It'll be a while until I have to worry about that. Wait, I thought that she was my guardian. Actually, that I was her guardian. Yeah, I want to be her guardian. I want to teach you to be Norwegian. If you're wondering where revolts happen, just click on the go-to place on top. One of three buttons on top. Yeah, I don't have trouble finding it. Usually just the hostile siege menu is enough, but the go-to place on top is actually also not bad. Ugh. But yeah. The Yazidi heresy has appeared in the county of Aleppo. Whatever. We're getting some heresies in, but that's fine. That's probably actually going to turn out fine. Do we have anyone, someone who owes us favor? We have the Duke of Ungar that owes us favor. It's time for us to stay alone. If you have to click on the character, then it's one of the three buttons. Yeah. Not seeing that one. It's just treasury and choose a plot. It's usually just this. Oh yeah, of course, the right click. Yeah, I keep forgetting to use that one.
I've played this game for a really long time, and I usually just whenever a revolt happened, I usually just find the hostile siege.
But that's probably a good thing to know for the future. And it's one of these little things that I somehow haven't learned after playing this game for hundreds of hours. I'm actually closing in on the 1,000th hour soon. Maybe it's just a symptom of this game having lots of Atna buttons, so it's kind of easy to miss the functional one. Or maybe I'm just very bad at noticing these type of things. Could be some mix thereof. Okay, we're going to start building our hostile training ground in Kunigarth. We're going to enforce the demands of the Sunayan. I'm at 1.5k. Yeah. That's actually pretty sweet. Yeah, sure. I should sink their company more often. Getting more learning, more piety, seems quite fine. We've got about 458 dark power. We already have familiar. Everything's good like that. This is one of the few cases where I'm actually really glad we got a daughter, because I do kind of want to snub the HRE by grabbing a duchy from them through the inheritance on my eldest right now. Oh, yeah. This was a whole plan. Now, the current Duchess of Brittany will have a kid. Wait. Agnatic, cognatic. Oh, she changed her succession type to seniority? Oh, that sucks. Well, that's fine. We'll be able to do a war for their claim eventually, so that seems fine. But yeah, if you haven't been watching, we've been playing this for 250 years. We started as Iceland as the Catholic Duke of Iceland, and 250 years can do a lot for a dynasty's power. It seems, and we've through a whole lot of political manipulation, scheming, and all the typical Crusader King stuff, have forged a somewhat impressive empire. But and so has the HRE. Their crusades have really gotten them a lot of territory, both here and here. We did take a chop of the Byzantines, but the Byzantines managed to expand all the way north here, which is actually quite annoying, because it's really hard to be a big empire fighting down a big empire that is within your religion group is relatively annoying to do in Crusader Kings. Especially since now all three of us, if I remember correctly, have gotten, primogeniture. All of them are primogeniture, I believe. Yeah. The two of us, all the three titles are agnatic, cognatic, primogeniture, so it's a lot harder to do some inheritance manipulation for the entire empire. I've been trying for a while to get a claim on the HRE on the right person, but it hasn't really worked out. I already was in your stream once with this file. I'm sorry, but I don't actually remember that. I'm also really feeling a bit down right now. I skipped work today because, throat's all sore and a whole other bunch of things. This is worrying. Okay, now the question is, what do we do now? Literally all of us. Well, the Byzantines aren't in a defensive pact against you, but actually, Argonaut did defensive pact against us, but we do have a truce with them, so that's probably not gonna help a whole lot. And there doesn't seem to be a very viable way. Let me see. How old is there? Three. Yeah, we don't have a male of our dynasty to marry into over there. Yeah, we don't have any male members of the dynasty to actually inherit, so.
we can't really try to put a claim in claim into each other's empire right about now. Almodista Kunigarth, which is not my heir, she wants to learn her own. But this is the girl that we really want to get as many beneficial stats as possible. Duchess Jurin of Saxony. I mentioned why you choose this capital where other provinces end up were way better, if you remember. Oh, yeah. I made Kunigarth my champion, Athna capital eventually, because it's just more centralized. It lets me use those capital bonuses bonuses in a lot more flexible manner. It also has 6 holding slots. So I've really just decided that Kunigarth is my capital. And I've also built it up decently a bunch. Like, the only really annoying thing about it is that it isn't coastal, but I've honestly, invested enough in it at this point where I'm just okay with it being my capital. Yeah, it even seems that, let me see, we're with England over Edessa. There seem to be, there seems to be, what claims do we actually have? County of Verdun, Theme of Alania. We could. But we don't really want to be a truce breaker right now. We have enough factions building up that we don't really want to exacerbate that right now. Theme of Direkion. Sheikdom. Not really quite worth it. Theme of Cherson, County of Messenia, County of Demetrius. Duchy of Salerno. We can try to claim Sicily. Wait, they're not in a defensive pact against us? All we have to fight is the County of... How are they not in a defensive pact against us? That's fascinating. Sicily... Her heir would be... What is the inheritance type of the Duchy of Sicily? Ecnatic, cognatic, gavel kind. Let me see. Her heir would be the eldest sons, and these would be the eldest son. That wouldn't actually get me. This is just the county of Messina. All that would do is put a new ruler on Sicily that would have a really high opinion modifier of me, but that would probably not, since we're not de jure rulers of that, it probably wouldn't actually gain us the title. And because we can't grant her titles, I don't think we'll be actually be able to snatch this one. Her current heir is the Countess of Messina. Who isn't... Now I really want this character to die. Because there's a few marriages here and there that we want to do with boys, and we have that, but that's not really going to help with the 12 years old patrol that you marry. And I don't think we have the opportunity to change the inheritance type to absolute cognatic. Do you have any best to boost your income if you're this big? I actually do have a total of 1. I have Visby, which is up here in Sweden. I don't have any more than that, and there just hasn't been a convenient time to form one other than Visby. Although Visby's been a nice little one. Let me see. We propose that princess. Somebody who don't care about, and one of his that seems fine.
war for we could claim Dalmatia. If we could, we would have to fight literally everyone on the planet, but we could try to claim Dalmatia. Pushing up there, but I don't think that actually would be, because they're on both sides of the coast, that's going to be a whole clusterfuck to deal with. Although, all of their capitals are cities. And their four levels above that aren't amazing. But the Croatian troops that we can get there first was only about 1,000. Then the Hungarian troops about 7. 14. Could we outspeed the rate at which that the HRE and the Byzantine Empire would get us? We probably could. And with Dalmatia down, put under that duke, we could maybe push a little bit more into Italy. There's some weird things going on in Italy, though. Like, the Spoleto is still an independent here. Urbino is actually independent, is an independent independent republic in Urbino. That, you don't see that happening every day. We probably would be able to, if not for the distant realm. We probably would even be able to vassalize that if we're not for the distant realms penalty. We've been pushing the borders here. Well, I'm going to continue to try to kill a boss in Cuphead. Oh yeah, so Furry Harper's going into that whole craze. Let me see. Focus. Sure. Go ahead and be all prideful. Why not? Seeks to kill somebody. We're not going to try to steal a claimant in there. Just barely is distant realm. Whoa, we're not suspicious anymore, and that's great. Wait, Russia, who are you fighting? Oh, you're just trying to revoke something. Norway. Defending against a revolt. That all seems fine, but fine by me. But the question is, will I be able to change my inheritance type into absolute cognatic? I would need no vassal or count above. He has a negative opinion on me, and if you look at the vassals, there's a whole lot of them that don't like me, but let me see. The King of Poland doesn't like me too much. King of Rus almost despises me somehow. For what reason? Female heir, wife's royalties, and a fair amount of my negative traits. Yeah, it's mostly just my negative traits that are really thrashing the opinion down, modifier down, and I don't think I'll be able to change the inheritance type with this character. I don't think it's actually a thing that's worth going for. We don't want to make a vassal war declarations illegal. One of the few things that we actually might want to do is for full status of women, but we don't get that until tolerance 6. We're at 5, and it's going to be a while until we get up to 6. Oh yeah, we also had a whole other plan here. The question is, we have one claimant who is a count elsewhere. That doesn't quite work.
your Duchy of Jerusalem? Let's see, Duchy of Jerusalem is being currently held by the Queen of France. The question is, how close are we to usurping? Who is he at war with? Attacking in Jerusalem's holy war for Damascus, that seems fine. What's the moral authority of the Sunni at the moment? I'm guessing not too high, as some normally Sunni dukes are Catholic in Andalusia. Well, the Shiite is 57, and the Sunni is 0. The moral authority of the Sunnis has been tanked utterly to 0. And that's honestly been a big effort on mine and the Byzantines and the Holy Roman Empire. The three of us have been pretty good at curb stomping the Abbasids, the Muslims, whenever we can. Although this has left an originally Muslim dynasty as being long-time Christian dukes here, and their territory is kind of an annoying swath. And just to, I've definitely said this a few times, but it's still worth noting that this map has a fair bit of border gore going on it right now. There's just a lot of border gore here and there. Like, I have the one county over there, the one county over there, and it's just a whole mess. Let me see. The Fatimids are also in our defensive pack, so we would have to fight literally the entire world to declare war at them. I can claim all of Jerusalem in the name of Count of Thours. Would we be able to crush this before doing anything else? I think the answer is actually yes, so I'm actually going to do that. Because, for one, just raising the armies that's like straight in their face, we have the French. The Irish troops, which are, you know, not embarrassing themselves. The English troops, the Hungarian troops. What was this? Yeah, the Norwegian troops can come too, sure. What is this anyway? Yeah, the Scottish troops. The Scottish troops, some personal levy, and... Ooh, my marshal tells me that one of my commanders, Andreas... one of my commanders. It's still fine. Count Gulliver has usurped the little bishopric. Yeah, whatever. Oh yeah, I forgot about that. The Count of Hebron is a bit weird, because he actually has a bunch of other titles. He's the County of Jerusalem, he has the County of Tyrus, the County of Beirut. He has a lot of titles overall. Do you really want to lead troops and eventually die? Kind of, yeah. Like, I honestly think it's fine for the moment, because... Okay, I'll have like 4 years of regency, but then I'll be up with a queen. I will have consolidated a couple of counties in the Byzantine Empire over to me. So I can't really say that I'd be too upset at dying right now. I would prefer it happening a couple of years later, maybe. But honestly, if I die now, it's kind of fine. I can. Sure, I can probably use some more of my being head of the Lucifer's own abilities, like the Absorb Light Force, the Unholy Impregnation, if I want to create the Antichrist eventually. Can I do that, by the way? Let's invite a disciple of Satan into the court. Welcome to my court, inferior. And I'm going to... 21, that's not quite good. Good, but... My wife hosts my wife stat-wise. My wife's got pretty good stats, so I think I'm actually going to make sure to designate my current wife as the regent. Castile, you keep trying. You do you. But like, yeah, to be serious, to be perfectly serious, dying right now is mostly fine. So I'm just gonna lead troops, and it'll just besides that, the actual odds of actually dying aren't even that big. Like, they can happen, and it's kind of like the odds of actually dying in battle aren't not really that bad, and right now I'm kind of just okay with taking that risk. The realm's otherwise mostly stable. If I die, I get rid of all of the pinion penalties that I have for the various things that this character's done. Well, I get rid of some of them, to be honest. Some of them, at least. Oh, let's record a court physician, though. I better not have to wait too long. Just become proud instead. See. No, but Bishop of Sagerborg, you'll be my doctor. That seems fine. Now we're looking at a city, so that'll turn out just fine. We'll be at least be able to consolidate our Jerusalemite territory, and that'll at least be something. Sure, Notbor must learn on his own. Siege down the church just fine. I'm actually wearing. Was the claim for the kingdom? The claim was for the kingdom, and he is a count in the realm, so that actually would absorb the entire empire. Actually, it would absorb the kingdom. Juxtle also reminds me, maybe I should be sieging some of these territories. At least Aragon and Castile and Navarra, they can at least do a little bit besiege that down. Are they? Yeah, no, okay, that guy's got a strong claim, okay, that makes sense. It's assigned to Lilo. Huskell Training Ground built in Saint Simon. That seems decent at least. That'll leave. Oh yeah, we can actually raise up a couple thousand more troops too. Well, 1,600 to be exact, but eh. It's not an unreasonable amount. Wait. Eh, we'll just keep those troops back. Jerusalem. Oh, there's also a Venetian trade port here. Yeah, it's being shown as being almost entirely sieged, even though it is entirely sieged, because we have some holdings in there. Truce expiring with whom even? Basically the Sana. I don't remember why we were at war with those with that guy in the first place. I have no idea. Commander, it looks like we're going to be winning that one. Ooh. Although there's a stack coming there that looks a bit troubling. Yeah, we're taking a bit of a hit there in the troops, but I think it's fine. Ooh. He takes the surrender. He might actually offer it to us before this message reached. King Arnaud the Usurper has usurped the titles of the Kingdom of Jerusalem from Duke Robin of Valencia. Perfect. Just disband all of our soldiers here. And that actually might mean that I might be able to do a whole other thing. Oh, sorry, de jure. I was looking at de jure. Kingdom of France. Empire of Francia. I currently control 78%. I need a single county. That's being helped by a revolt, but do we have anyone that has the claim on Duchy of Upper Burgundy? Steiermark? Yeah, okay, that's that remark. But this revolt, we're definitely declaring a war on this revolt to try to take something. Tyrol is just like that one county, Brandenburg is also one country, and Steiermark is all the way down over there. It's these two counties that are essentially both in Upper Burgundy. Do we have a claimant on Upper Burgundy? He has only has that one county. Prince Paul of Lüneburg, who is a German who has that one county, but what we need is Upper Burgundy. We're going to need someone who is going to be willing to be part of our court. It's Johan currently, who doesn't have a regency though. So in order to be able to pull that claim, we're going to need someone with a strong claim, and well, this one does have a strong claim, but is married to someone who is an old duke within the empire, so that doesn't work. And Paul, Count of Lüneburg, has a strong claim, but is actually also part of the empire. Let's see if we can actually make that better. Wait, Pisa? Pisa is these three counties and a whole bunch in... Yeah, I'm not really willing to fight everybody in order to fight Pisa. And that's currently what I'm out now. That's what the current proposition is. So, how do we get the right claim on the right places? We can claim Brandenburg, which is Steiermark and Tyrol. The County of Brandenburg, County of Steiermark. Are there any other duchies that we might be able to claim? I'd really like it if just a couple of them. That's it. We need one county, which is either Pisa or... Well, this looks pretty drained. Nope, but what about the county of Swiss? Maybe there's a... How much does the Pope like me? I'm guessing, yeah, Pope hates me, so we're not gonna get the claim that way. No one's willing to join McCurt to take the county of Brandenburg, but... Currently, the Duke of Austria is on the loyalist side of things. Corinthian, so that doesn't quite add up. Let's see, can we actually get a favor out of at least one of them? Send gift. Who's got a claim on the duchy? Oh, but it's a weak claim, but they're having a revolt, so... Wait, that probably doesn't count. Intriguing, I guess a little reading can't hurt. Oh, we also have 1,000 money stacked up? Might as well. How tuna? Don't really care that much about what can be built here. Sure.
other Huskarls running around. Another Huskarl training ground here. And that should do it. These orthodox secret orders haven't died out yet, despite of our efforts. I mean, there's still a bit of orthodox here and there. Court chaplain. So you're doing nothing valuable. Yeah, he's been trying to convert that for a while without much success. We have even some Sikrian Suomenesco here and there, but it's not too bad for the most part. Let me see. It's assigned to Lilo. Nah, we still can't claim it. Actually, wait, that's actually true. Her titles. If there's anything, because... Yeah, we already checked Corinthia. There are no good titles for Corinthia. That's fine, whatever. Duchy of Verona. Yeah, okay. She doesn't have any duchies titles that are in jeopardy. I wish really we could chop the right counties, but we just don't have the claims for them. I really wish you had the kind of EU4 option where you could just buy land away from people, because I would probably try to buy Nike off here for some amount of money. Try to attempt to abduct him. I think that's probably what the plan's gonna go. Actually, maybe that's actually something. If I could, unfortunately. I will let Alice oversee the construction, that seems fine. Well, then she cousin French can't walk that way. Yeah, I really wish I could. You try to vassalize the Pope so he gives you claims eventually, just try to approve relations or set up an anti-pope to claim the papacy. Claiming an anti-pope doesn't seem all that bad. I don't seem to have the right stuff for it right now. Let me see, 66. Actually, I might be able to. Doing an anti-pope is a strategy that I actually just really haven't been bothered to do a lot. Oh yeah, I can't do it because there's been an anti-pope recently. I don't remember where. I don't know. I think it was in the HRE, because there's no one else big enough. Free investiture. I think I do have free investiture. Yeah, I do have free investiture. The thing that the reason why I can't make an anti-pope right now, as we see right here, is because an anti-pope has been recently deposed, which is unfortunate. Although we should probably, unfortunately, by the look of territory versus territory, I don't think that this rebellion is going to succeed. So I might as well just going to benefit off of it. Because this war is actually in order to make Gavelkind happen, and if Gavelkind would actually happen, that would be amazing. Because all of this, if we just look at the HRE right now, du jour, the HRE du jour, and even outside of that, they would basically lose almost everything that's not in their du jour that would then become independent, which would leave them with a whole mess of problems. So I would really like them to win, but I don't think they can win. Actually, I wonder. Actually, that would be pretty funny, but no, I don't think. Money, but I don't think you can a favor because she's closely related to the king. Although she's not in her court right now, so that actually might work. You could get give the revolt some money so they can hire mercenaries. I could do that, but each gift to them is a minimum of 400, and that's not really a guarantee, and it's not even going to guarantee that they're going to hire mercenaries. Because their odds, current odds of succeeding, just if you look at their numbers, they've got 26,000, which, you know, it's not bad, but if you look at... Wait, what? 1626... Actually, that doesn't seem like that bad of an idea. I mean, there are more loyalist vassals, of course, that might do something about this, but if they succeed, which I don't think they will. Why would I want to kill him? He's just a count in my empire. It's fine. Sure, I'll try to send them gift and leave them alone and see what happens. Because if they succeed, I smell profit. It's going to be a huge deal. Because, like, I could also just attack them and try to take a county or so, but the odds of this potentially helping us are just too great. I mean, we don't have that much time to take advantage of it, really, but we'll see what happens. Oh, can actually get some technologies. Religious customs, we can also get. Here, we'll just get more heavy infantry. Married matrilineally into a prince of the Holy Roman Empire. And it's also agnatic primogeniture, so it's very hard to actually manipulate the stats. Right. I wonder. Yeah. They're not really willing to give me anyone that's that's high in the succession order like that. She's probably got a weak claim. Casper's got a strong claim. And a weak claim that can be inherited. Yeah, but that doesn't actually allow me any... any claims that I might be able to fight for. Let's examine the Byzantines for a little bit. There's a kinswoman of mine with a weak claim, but it just doesn't really help that much. Because they don't have a regency. A couple more people with weak claims. Well, there are weak claims, but maybe. The guy in our dynasty is married to a countess in Scotland. Never mind that she's excommunicated. Currently married into that. But let's actually see if we plot to kill, and let's also taint it, touch him. Because if he dies, goes into a regency, we find someone of our dynasty to put on that throne, the inheritance goes right. We might be able to absorb the Byzantines, and that actually would be incredibly useful. We also have one family of dukes in the Byzantine Empire that is of our dynasty. Yeah, there's no independent realms that are of our dynasty as of yet. Not right now, there used to be, because Castile used to be... of our dynasty. Brittany, I thought Brittany would, but Brittany's inheritance type seems to have put a sock in that. Oh, we have cancer. That's not great. How old is my oldest? 13. Glad I heard Ale. Yeah, she's a duchess of her own, which means I can't really arrange her betrothal, but that's fine. Oh, she's betrothed to one of my own, but I'm probably going to break that betrothal, actually. And I'm probably going to try to marry maybe someone in the either the Byzantines or the Holy Roman Empire to do some shenanigans with. Are they in the defensive pact against me now? Yep, they're in the defensive pact against me, because why wouldn't they be? I can try to claim the Byzantine. They still would be independent, as if it's the same emperor tier title, so I don't really see the point of this. Well, it would enable a potential future marriage to combine the empires together. So essentially, if you just find the right heir that can marry the heir of the other empire, and this can sometimes absorb all of their land through and through. But you would have to, of course, first fight this war, which you would have to fight absolutely everyone on. You would have to fight absolutely everyone, and that actually would be very, very annoying. annoying to deal with, and he's probably just going to get usurped, so I don't think it's worth it. But if there was that moment where we could take that chance with fighting just the Byzantines for that war and not before they joined the defensive pact, I would have actually tried to go for this, but it doesn't seem like it's a good idea right now. Yeah, because our threat's also just stuck at around 100 because we've been doing too well, really. Ooh, he finally has converted a county. Whoop-de-fucking-do. Oh no, he hasn't. He's just converted a subject. Never mind. He's even less competent than I thought he was. I'm suffering from food poisoning. Well, let's see if dark healing, a little bit of dark healing, can't fix that right up. As long as you know what you're doing. We'll be as Hayden does. Oh, it loses food trading. I actually feel better. That's actually quite good. Still, yeah, okay. It still looks like I might live this one through. Oh, let's look how they're doing. 22%. Not bad. Not bad. And the moment that they get Gabelkind, we're gonna try to assassinate their emperor. And have them split up all. Is 5 years old, so you can push weak claims, so you can make your plan happen. I could, but one of the reasons why that I'm not sure if I'm gonna do that is I could put an emperor of my dynasty, but he probably would get. Yeah, but that's actually a good. One of the good points is that. He probably, yeah, because he's actually of my dynasty. And so he won't be able to inherit this. I guess it kind of is a now or never type of scenario where we just go all in. If it works, it works. It's just, he's 52. He's got children. He's got a son that'll inherit. He's a dwarf, but that's fine. If I could marry into that, I think he's a bit old, so it's a bit. This is still. I think I actually kind of agree. I think I'm kind of turned around on that. This is still very, very risky, but the potential yields of this are so humongous that it's probably worth trying to go for. Even though we have to fight. Basically everyone on the planet. And our strategy here, it will be to carpet siege the Byzantine Empire as much as we can. Yeah, we already raised Poland, but we haven't raised that the capital, we haven't raised Rus. Revolt. England, and some troops here. Well, actually, yeah, just sailing the French over from the Holy Land is probably the better course of action. Power. Summon familiar. I think we're just gonna need the marshal, so I'm going to say a wolf. And you could remove the Orthodox rules even for a moment, and if that works, the Orthodoxy will be gone soon. Yeah, that does tend to happen. That'll certainly weaken the Orthodox faith. I actually, because we do really need to get as many troops as we can. Sail some Aragonese troops. Did they? Oh, the Irish did have a coastal town here. But we can only reach 300 troops from the Irish for some reason. That's not worth diddly, is it? That's not worth a whole lot either. How much is Jerusalem worth, actually? Yeah, Jerusalem's worth like 3,000 troops, so that's probably worth it. Well, though we do probably have to rush it, and we actually might lose this war, and if we lose this war, we'll be out of a lot of money, and we won't be able to do anything for a real long while. Although, I probably won't surrender as long as it's not on 100. Oh, they're even fighting internal revolts. That's actually quite good. Let me see. Whatever. Don't care. Let's see if we can make that happen. Haldor Grimstadter. Sure. Let's see what we've got here. We've got the troops walking, running, marching all the way through here. That's fine. We've got some sieges here and there. We're just gonna ignore everything except the Byzantines itself. This actually might turn out pretty poorly for us, but we just might be able to pull through if we stick on carpet sieging the Byzantines. Things don't go too poorly. Straight from there, and we've got about 8k of troops worth of troops coming in here. Are the French in a war? Any other war other than us? Oh yeah, they're also fighting a holy war for Arabia. Hope that's probably not going to go well for them, but we'll see. If we capture Constantinople, the odds of us being able to maybe randomly capture the emperor himself would actually be game-winning almost instantly, so that's probably going to turn out well. Yeah, just stay in your boats. Yeah, they're a bit ahead of the curve on that one, but that should be fine. We can catch their armies, or we can siege Constantinople. I think we're going to try to carpet siege Constantinople. Highly suspicious will be removed. It takes about 20 days. Well, that guy's turning pretty bold about these things. because we can afford it as well, because we're getting about 40, even upholding all of these armies, we're getting like 40 ducats per month, or 40 money per month. We'll hire the Swiss band to join us as just sort of more, as just sort of just further reinforcements. Ooh, Cleaver. Beat it out of her. 15th of February. Okay, we're not going to be able to get that. I think of assassins. Okay, that's fine. Some adventurers trying to do something. 16th of February, 1322, in 2 years. This war will be either finished or close to finishing by then. Okay, I'm gonna give her, she deserves greatness, go get it, because ambitious is just such a good trait. And we really want that our intended heir to have. Got 15,000 men, more men incoming, so that's something. Now would be a good time to strike. Why do you keep doing that? I don't really want to kill my brother. He's very, very far away from the succession. And he's, like, a count somewhere. You can just keep that. Yeah, we're gonna fight that. We're gonna outnumber him, and everything's gonna be great. 3rd of April. Yep. And we have superior strategists, for the most part. Actually, no, we have superior strategists all the way, because actually they've got one general on one flank that's better, but by a very small margin. Oh. The Pope is attacking us as well. Wow, this is a whole mess. Defeat here and there, this seems fine. Let me see. I'll show the Fall War. Curses. That seems fine. We surrender in these terms, gain 100% count. Accept. Now, does he have? We have no potential alliance to propose, though, which is unfortunate. There, yeah,
Which is, again, unfortunate, but... Wait. I don't think we have a truce with the guy. I'm actually curious about one thing. Disband. Finally, finally, you've been able to manage to convert the county. So, next up is Tiver. Just keep getting at that. There's a count that's trying to claim the empire that has 6,000 troops versus his 12,000 troops. We hope that we just hope that he wins that one. Poland has declared a war for Hamadan. Just doing a little bit of expansion here in the Middle East. That seems about just about right. Okay, now we have an emperor on the Byzantine throne that is of our dynasty. And if we look at the dynasty view, it's very, very impressive. But now, essentially, what the problem we have is we're gonna lay down all of our levies. What did excommunicated ruler then? Excommunicated lifted. Emperor Grimbison abdicates to Capre. Yeah, okay. It's essentially his son immediately inherits. That's all that happens there. We can claim the Byzantine Empire away from him, but we can't claim it in a way that it benefits us immediately. How's this war doing? 30%! They're actually still doing well here. Poland, who are you fighting? Aye, you're fighting Hamadan. Yay, I just looked at that earlier. See, what is our threat level? Threat level is still at 97 anyway, and it's not going to go away by the end of this. Syria and Baghdad. This is in two different counties. But Baghdad, though. Was Baghdad not a holy site in any religion? I thought it was. Oh, sorry. This is Samarra, not actual Baghdad. Because actual Baghdad is, yeah, here. And that one's an actual holy site. We can try to take Samarra. It would mean slightly less border gore, among other things. How's the revolt doing? 16%? Yeah, sure, let's do that. See how that goes. Yeah, and if we would actually be able to absorb the Empire, we would get rid of even more border gore along those lines. Wait a minute. Did I take that? Yeah, it was for the Kingdom of Mesopotamia. I took that. That went better than expected, honestly. Now we have Emperor Grimm the Usurper, who is a Byzantine emperor. Actually, for the future, though, his son's wife, I'm gonna kill her. Because I want her to be... I want him to be married to the right person. That's fine. I think my wife's cheating on me, but I think it's fine. Although I have a hunchback for my heir is a hunchback, which isn't great. There's someone to find out. Oh no, that's right. Yeah. She was only Craven. It's the other daughter, the one that isn't going to inherit, that's a hunchback. This one's only Craven and Envious, which is not great, but not terrible traits. Also, I probably have a lot of prisoners to sell off now. Let's just do that like that. Oh, she's 15. They grow up so fast. She's gonna be over. She's gonna be of age soon. And we're reaching the age of 40 soon. School training ground. Rather, let's just get better house girls in Mosul. Let's make sure we just have the best of the best in the capital. Yeah. Let's assault that. And that'll be over soon. Played for about 5 years now. We've been able to put the exact emperor that we want. Yeah, we can't really force anyone to kill her. Let's take to touch that one. Decline. But I enjoy them, so that seems fine. We'll just... The Duchy of Aragon is no longer considered de jure part of the Kingdom of Aragon. Yeah, but that actually doesn't change the Empire de jure. Which is really what we would care about. I think I'm actually, I'm just going to rush. I'm thinking about maybe you're just rushing the Pisans down. To the Kingdom of Finland. Yeah, my half-sister is still queen. Edmund of England. Oh, yeah. Too many held duchies. Duchy of Carolyn. Okay, we don't need that one. Let me see. Too many health clusters to charge the Duchy of Estonia. Also have the Duchy of Estonia. That should do that at least. I grant you the Duke Duchy of Carolyn. What else does the Duchy of Benevento? You don't really need that one. Let's just, in order to try to piece things out. Also, Kingdom of Wales and the West Midlands. Actually, and the Duchy of Gwynedd. You will be the Duke of De Boyners. It doesn't hate me nearly as much. Do we still have the too many duchies penalty? No. I'm gonna make him master of the horse of the empire. Now he doesn't mind me too much. I should keep him from causing too much trouble. This also lets me fill out my domain a little bit, which actually is pretty fine. A little bit more direct tax. Yeah, we don't have enough legalism to push the obligations anymore, more any one way or the other. So that should do me just fine. He's still Catholic, which is fine by us. Okay, good. Really don't want him to inherit, so gotta be a little bit careful about it, because we really want to now gain up to 500. How much are we gaining per month? Nine, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. So we're gonna need a cup a year. Would generate a fair amount. We don't have any missions at the moment. Actually, no vessels are fighting it. No vessel. Can we? Actually converted another province. Let's see actually if we can get absolute cognatic, because we otherwise wouldn't mind having the sun. Make him high almoner. Wants to be on the council. Is worth 20 roughly. Another 61. Oh, that's a revolt, and we can end those. That's a revolt, and we can end those. A few counts. And dukes, Corpuna. We can hide some of them. It's tough, but I think we can actually pull that off. King of Mesopotamia. Rus. Bullshit, we're just gonna give him the county of Telemark. think we can actually do it. Hungary has... So if we give him the rest of Samara, that's like 80. Okay, he's taken care of. King of Castile. His is only worth like 131 money. This will probably be more expensive. With Galicia. Peace with Aragon. Peace with Norway. Give the King of Denmark a gift. Peace with Scotland. Peace with Perm. Peace with Jerusalem. Peace with Denmark. Peace with Jerusalem. Peace with Jerusalem. It's only your vassals, not all of your vassals' vassals. He really doesn't like me. Just give him over to Russia, I think. And let's see, what other kings can are actually troublesome that aren't just revolters anyway that we don't care about, don't care about. And her we'll just give over to Castile, I think. Unfortunately, wait. Oh, yeah. Portugal, okay, that makes more sense. Yeah, the King of Portugal's been there for a while. But that's actually something he might lose if this revolt actually sticks. That's a ceremonial weapon. Wait. Cleaver. Oh, wait, yeah, that's actually her only actual weapon. Yeah, carry the ceremonial weapon of the Sword of Heroes. We don't actually have any good crowns, though. Increased council power. Hero I have, sister. Oh. So, yeah. And that too should settle it. Let me see. Hungry. That should do it. Yeah, with that out of the way, that revolt's not gonna happen. Wait until we get the money. I knew power had its price, but never this significantly. No vassals are fighting each other. It's each other. I want you to surrender to England. Oh shit, I forgot that I need to also have the tolerance at 6. Of Croatia. I'm not lustful anymore. I really want that. That's my parent, especially since the other guy's too young. I need 500. Just need to survive for a bit longer. Seems to be doing well. Here, a good diplomatic. Good diplomat is always useful. Byzantine still dealing with a couple of revolts.
probably want to keep the queen here. Disband the army. And if we can somehow also get the Byzantine Empire title, that would actually be quite wonderful. Not my de jure fleet, foreign culture, mage reluctance. Tonic Order is probably just going to stay there for a little while. Accursed heathens. Oh yeah. Probably should have done that while I was... Double kind. Here we go, 200 more cash. Yeah, the Holy Roman Empire looks like it's fighting back. So it seems unlikely that this revolt will actually succeed. Fabricate a claim on the Duchy of Barcelona. Whatever, that seems pretty much irrelevant. I don't want to throw him in jail, honestly. I think this is fine. Could you check if he already has replaced some of the Orthodox vassals of his? Honestly, it's been such a short time, so I'm guessing not. What's this revolt about? I think in Byzantine revolts for Barbaras. Let me see. I don't think he has. He's honestly dealing with a whole bunch of revolts on his own. I think Barbara, I think this is the one.
Let's see if we can keep influencing the Byzantines. I don't think so, because religiously, it looks like it's still all Orthodox, especially if you look at the Orthodox. Yeah, they're all Orthodox. He has not replaced any vassals at this point. Well, with Christians anyway. Unlimited power. Great Lord, I seek power. Blessing of Azazel, giving +3 martial and some extra dark power that we do actually kind of need. Because I think we're going to absorb our little kid. Would you like to form an alliance? The Polish Hungarian Russian Scandinavian forces. Yeah, 26,000 troops, so that should be enough. That'll also let him rack up a little bit prestige. A bit of prestige. Accept. Actually, it does look like he has a few more troops than I thought he did, so let's toss in the French. And the Jerusalem Lamites. That should help a lot. Did we have any other empire titles? No, we only had one empire title, which is the Empire of Scandinavia. The only one we need. Let's see if we can make things happen. On the stink, that seems fine. It's a whole lot of trouble, but if we manage to absorb the Byzantine Empire into
ours, and it'll be all worth it. During the Teutonic War for Gergely's claim on Heves. Yeah, that's not gonna go well for him. That's not gonna go well for them at all. We got about 60,000 men fighting each other. It ain't nothing. Excellent. I am now brave. My marshal is 22, which is not bad. It's all good. Victory over there. This will probably let him do a purge, though. Let me see. They hold on to the chest. They held out. And until just the last moment where the Scandinavian hammer could thwart them down. This is actually going pretty well. I just hope
hope that we can absorb the Byzantine Empire properly. What happens again if we enforce peace against the Teutonics? We get about 700 money, we'll be bankrupt for a while, and we'll get prestige. That seems fine. We're gonna be make sure to smack those down. You get the most war progress if you siege the revolt's leader direct holdings. Yeah, you usually do, but what's closest is just more convenient to go at.
Sure.
Yeah, everybody's in the defensive pact against me for good reason. Still a Byzantine revolt going on. If you could only stop that, that would be so much more convenient. Just gotta make sure to crush these revolts for him. Is it? Did I decline? I thought I accepted. Agnatic cognatic primogeniture. Why didn't a son inherit? I'm confused. He was even born in the purple. Oh no. Wait, what happened? The faction demands. Well, that'll just have to be a very disappointing end to this session, as we were willing to stick by the previous emperor. To be emperor is now Duke's Empires. Well, I suppose that achieved something. Not a whole lot, but something. Now there are two different Dukes of our dynasty in this empire. Frigimina, Gimina, Aurora Kid, Arpa. None of them. The only one that's of our dynasty is
nearest war creature you created died off. Basically. Oh, unfortunately, yes. And now currently, he's the other guy, the guy who I put on the throne, became a vassal inside the other empire, so I can't put him on the throne again. Female leaders with claimed as male, regencies, that is all contested. Okay. Weak claims, I can still press, should be able to press this one. Action demand doesn't. Well, at least this guy's turning around gavel kind of a little bit better. Things we do for life. Because I want the Duchess Jorin to be my heir. Because that way, I at least get Saxony and get that away. Funnily enough, now I kind of want this revolt to succeed. Because if this revolt succeeds, that means a duke of my dynasty will become independent. And I believe, yeah, he's pretty much got all that territory. I hope that actually goes well. Strategist, doesn't that mean that's a vice royalty? Or like a theme. Yeah, much royalty. That's a very strategist or strategisa. Kaisaros, this guy actually might enable me to steal some land away from the other Byzantines I have. Done a little bit of that, but few and far between. It's been little and not, like, a lot of it and not often. This war might do something eventually, but I don't think I have to worry about it. Because I'm feeling a bit sick and off the weather, I think I'm gonna end this game early right now. But I will be here hopefully next Monday to continue Monday Monarchs. And when Jade Dragon comes down, I have something a little special planned, so watch out for that. So, until next week, may your dreams be ever filled with conquest. Count John D. out.